speed. Oh, go ahead.
We're rolling?
Still rolling.
Rolling.
Action!
Ghost of Old Highways is really a song about rebirth. One man's journey into the darkness of his own labyrinth, a battle with his demons, and then a return.
When I wrote this song, I never thought that it would involve having a stunt double. It was never something that occurred to me.
Boom!
I was first introduced to Ben probably about 5 or 6 years ago when we were working on the soundtrack for The Signal, which is the first film that we made.
Which was a film that I scored. They had three directors, and Dan was one of them, but we only really got to make a third of a movie together. And so we had been looking for an opportunity to work on something together again.
When I first heard the album, I listened to the entire album, and it seemed like every song was a different story within a larger epic of what all classic stories are about.
And when this project came along where people were coming forward with ideas about visual components for the Highway Collection project, Dan just came forward and was like, Ghost, I want Ghost.
The song's about ego death. It's about looking at the parts of yourself that you disagree with. We all have pieces of ourselves that we, from our past, previous versions of ourself, that we hate. Things we've done, regrets.
It was such a playground for ideas inside of what we were developing on the story that it was just kind of like, we're making a film, we're making a movie. The way we approached it was like we were making a movie. We were always making a movie. We just didn't really know it until we were out there.
Oh, you mean on my feet? Like,
yeah, just come into it so that you land right there.
Baseball slide.
Yeah. Ben is not an actor. Ben is an amazingly talented musician, singer, songwriter, composer. Like, the guy's a genius. But he's not an actor. So going in the back of my head, there's worry about how well it'll be pulled off. And I was worried he was going to push himself too far.
I felt like it was my job as the director and the writer to take what I got, what Ben had given me in his song and in his music, and to find a way through the poetry of image and narrative to convey that.
I grew up in a part of the world that got its ass kicked in the Civil War. There's really no glory in that part of history for where I come from. And so it kind of hangs over the South as this ghost of its own. There's really nothing about the film that's specific to the Civil War or about the Civil War.
Action!
We just were calling upon a certain time, a certain look, a certain era, because it's in our range of interest and it seemed to apply to the theme of the song.
Lovett's going down.
And I thought to myself, a period piece on a shoestring budget, what could possibly go wrong?
A few weeks before we shot, we took Ben to Black Knight's stunts and we worked with Nils Onzinger and Elizabeth Davidovich and Justin Wellborn.
Boom! Get in, smack it!
And we got a really good double for Ben and Bobby.
That's where I met Ben. We got to talk to each other, kind of just fill out what he's capable of and kind of get to what they wanted.
Me and Ben and Bobby all started working together on the stunts and choreographing them. And Ben did all his own stunts and Bobby did all his own stunts because Bobby wasn't just a double. He wasn't just a stunt double. He was actually in there with Ben. And when they were fighting, they were really fighting each other.
We couldn't have made this without Bobby. I mean, he's what really made all this work.
The entire film is a chase. So Bobby was running, constantly chasing Ben, and then they would switch clothes, and Ben would be chasing Bobby. And every time, no matter who was chasing who,
action.
I was chasing both of them with a steady cam, the full rig, you know, built out, up the mountain, down the mountain.
We had to kind of have an agreement that we got to both do the stunts because, like, the stunts are fun. They're dangerous, but that's why they're fun. And so I always wanted to do them, but everybody on the the producers and the director, everybody was just like, you know, if you break your ankle right now, this is day one. If you hurt yourself now, this whole thing is shot.
Sorry.
Well, that was good.
And he was, you know, being hung from a tree. He was jumping with an axe. He was being drowned. He was being shot at. He was jumping in rivers, jumping off balconies, you name it. He was doing all sorts of stuff. And a lot of times we had a stunt player do it, but more times than not, it was usually him.
Yeah. Ben starts coming up, grabbing and pushing back in the water.
I mean, Ben got his ass kicked on this job, day in and day out. Even in the prep, when we were rehearsing at Black Knight, he really gave it his all.
I talked my way into a few of them, and actually the very first shot on the very first day is me leaping off like a third-story balcony, which I insisted to do because it was the first thing we were going to shoot.
Okay, did you kill him? Walk out and check. Wait, he's not there. Get his ass.
Nice. Nice shot.
Run!
We started this project, and when I first had the idea of going to Black Balsam Knob, I knew it was going to be difficult. I knew that it would be trying and stressful, and I knew that we needed the right people.
Having no budget and shooting on a mountain doesn't really make people flock to your flag, really.
With the location, it was beautiful, but it was like a third of a mile hike at like maybe a 30 degree incline the whole time. And then you're talking about moving camera gear and grip gear and lighting gear up this mountain.
This literally became a film that was carried by the hands and on the backs of its crew members.
We had the best crew. I mean, the best crew. We could not have gotten this project made without the crew that we had.
We're hiking all this gear just through this thick fog on these mountain trails. And then the clouds rolled out, and everyone could see for miles in every direction. It was one of the few places that you could find that still looks like it did then.
I mean, as a cinematographer, I looked around and was just like, there is nowhere I can look that's not pure beauty.
It's like, well, we could shoot the scene, the wedding scene this way, or we could shoot it that way, or we could shoot it, I mean, any way we looked was fantastic.
There's five different looks, because there's five different bends in the movie, and each of those bends represent a different mask or face and transition of what the story's about.
What I asked from Caroline is to have something that was nondescript, something that was old world, early American, but not specific to any given date or time period.
I took the Civil War soldier idea and other time periods and kind of hodgepodge them together and molded them, took a little bit from here and a little bit from there, and kind of came up with my own period, if you will, that doesn't really exist.
I think that was exciting for her because she got to, instead of being stuck to researching a specific period, she got to sort of choose and pick from her favorite within a whole scope of about, you know, 100 years.
The creative process with Dan is always a lot of fun because you kind of sit there and just bounce ideas off of each other.
Wonderful thing about Jesse Clarkson is when you start to talk to him about stuff, when you come to him with an idea, he comes right back at you with his own immediately. He engages right away. And I started talking to him about the special gun that I wanted our hero to have.
And I always wanted to build a six-barreled revolver, you know, a revolving musket.
It's this six-barreled chamber where all the barrels themselves rotate.
Elements of, like, you know, Civil War, Wild West, but a steampunk, just keeping it as kind of off-center as possible.
So at the point that the idea for this video ballooned into a film, the idea we had was to score the film in the style of the song. I originally recorded the song with the band Ponderosa, who happened to be, years later, at the same studio that I went into to record the music for the film. And I was like, we have to do this together. Let's just go in a couple of days before you guys leave, and let's just do the music for this together. Why not? It seems like the most appropriate thing to do.
it just was one of those strange things that seemed meant to be.
Was I right?
Keep doing that. Hey, so it's going dun 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 halftime. And I think drums stop and we sustain for a minute. He sees the wedding, and now we're halftime building up to the top of the axe thing.
Talking about the kill theme, that's when the build happens, or the
We build from the time he takes off towards the wedding.
Yeah, 2:05.
Yep.
So it's the creation of new music based on the song that we did together.
I'll never get that right.
Not only does the song sort of bookend this entire project, but even the group of guys that I made the music with, it's so perfect that they're involved in it all the way through now. To get to have an opportunity to explore that with them again, that's the best.
That's cool. Let's do that again. That's feeling really good.
Ready, and action. No one was paid on this production. No one could hang their hat on anything other than a job well done.
Everybody was there as an artist, not as a crew member. And so everybody pitched in, and it didn't matter what department you were in, all lines were blurred.
You know, you'd be standing there and, you know, 1 minute it's 105 degrees, next minute it's pouring down rain. And, you know, there's no one to complain to. There's, you know, you've got the producer on one side, you're the director, and they're standing there with you just suffering through. We all had a smile on our face, and everybody kind of kept a positive attitude, just because everyone was there just for the pure love of it.
And everybody really came together to make it happen because they knew they were doing something really special. Really special.
And there was something in that sort of unified struggle that kind of bound everybody together. Everyone was willing to literally go the extra mile.
It was a hard experience, it was a tough experience, but at the end of the day, We had a blast making it.
And it wasn't for money or for prestige or for any of that. It was just to fucking do it. Because we could. That's awesome. That's awesome.
Run! We got him!
Let's go again right away.